The OnePlus 5T is here, and it's glorious. Honestly, ever since the rumors of a bezel-less OnePlus 5 came into existence, I have been eagerly waiting for it. And now that the OnePlus 5T is here, I am super excited to use it. However, before we bring you our full review, let's take a look at the OnePlus 5T. What's up guys, this is Rupesh from bbomb.com and today I'm going to talk about our first impressions of the OnePlus 5T. Before we start talking about the OnePlus 5T, make sure to hit the bell icon to get notifications for all our future videos. Now that you've done that, let's get started. First up, let's open up this big black box that we received from OnePlus. So this is the OnePlus 5T. It has the same anodized aluminium design from the OnePlus 5 and it's beautiful and classy. I was hoping for an IP certification but it's not there, so you still can't take your OnePlus device swimming with you. But a headphone jack makes up for it. The biggest change in the new OnePlus 5T comes in the form of a larger 6-inch optic AMOLED display. The big bezels from the OnePlus 5 are gone and that results in a sweet 18:9 display. And well, it looks gorgeous. It's still Full HD, Full HD Plus actually, but I don't really mind. OnePlus 5 had a great display, and this one in the OnePlus 5T seems even better. It is AMOLED and it's almost bezel-less. So yes, it looks beautiful indeed. OnePlus did talk about the display being a sunlight display. I haven't been able to test that just yet, but we'll talk about it in a full review. Now, as we've known for the past month or so, the bigger 18:9 display has resulted in the fingerprint scanner being moved to the back. I don't mind it, especially because OnePlus has placed it perfectly. But I know a lot of people, Akshay, who like fingerprint scanners on the front. So this is one sacrifice OnePlus had to make. However, OnePlus 5T includes a face unlock feature, which honestly nobody saw coming. So how is the face unlock experience? At first, I wasn't able to add my face in the OnePlus 5T even after multiple attempts. But the smartphone received an update which brought optimizations to face unlock and more. Just in time, OnePlus. After the update, I was able to add my face and unlock the OnePlus 5T. And well, it seems to work like a charm. OnePlus is using the trusted face feature from Android Smart Lock. So it's not the same level of 3D mapping that Face ID in the iPhone does, but it's very fast. Having said that, we will be testing out the face unlock feature thoroughly in the next few days. Another change that nobody saw coming in the OnePlus 5T is the new dual camera setup. Everyone knew the rear cameras will be improved, but OnePlus went ahead and included a 16-megapixel f1.7 primary camera and a 20-megapixel f1.7 secondary camera. Both have the same focal length, so yes, it's not a telephoto lens. OnePlus 5 did not offer mind-blowing low-light performance, and the company wants to change that with the OnePlus 5T. In our first few photos, the improvement is noticeable, but we'll make a judgment when we have captured a ton of photos. The portrait mode is here too, and taking portrait photos is easier, because the lack of a telephoto lens means that the viewfinder is not zoomed in when you switch to portrait mode. The portrait mode shots look good, but we have to see if things are better or worse without the telephoto lens. One weird thing is, there's still the 2x zoom button when there's no optical zoom. Apart from that, my thoughts on the OnePlus 5T camera are incredibly positive. Other than these upgrades, there is a new parallel apps feature in OxygenOS, which lets you use two iterations of the same app. Basically, you can use multiple accounts of an app like WhatsApp or Skype or basically any other social app. OxygenOS, by the way, is still Android 7.1 Nougat, with the Oreo beta coming in December. Well, my initial thoughts regarding the OnePlus 5T are definitely very positive. Because even though there were various leaks around the device, the company managed to bring a few surprises. The OnePlus 5T certainly brings more than expected. I'm not sure how OnePlus 5 users might be feeling, especially the ones who bought it last month, but what shipped is shipped. And I like the OnePlus 5T. I mean, it's priced exactly the same as OnePlus 5. And it seems to fix all the flaws in the OnePlus 5. So what's not to like? In fact, I was talking to Devinder about OnePlus 5T alternatives. And we came up with the conclusion that there is no capable OnePlus 5T alternative out there. Now that is saying something. So yes, OnePlus is on a roll with the OnePlus 5T. But let's not get too ahead of ourselves, because we are yet to fully test the device, which we will be doing in the next few days. So stay tuned for a full OnePlus 5T review. Well, those are our thoughts on the OnePlus 5T. Tell us what you think of the OnePlus 5T in the comment section below. Also, give this video a thumbs up and share it with your friends if you enjoyed it. And do subscribe to our channel for more awesome tech videos. Well, that's me signing off. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one.